API stands for Application Programming Interface.
Picture the flux capacitor from Back to the Future. To travel through time with this particular car, you would need both the flux capacitor, you need the car itself, and you need the interface, which is the steering wheel and the knob. Without all those components, the complete program would not work. This is how you build programs. You leverage data, or you leverage information from other systems, but that's only part of the problem. You have to complete the whole process by ensuring that you've captured everything you need to ensure that your program works.
I would say they expose something useful. In most instances, is usually data.
APIs can connect platforms, software applications, SaaS applications. They can connect even their APIs for desktop applications. APIs can connect to robotics. As long as the engineers who built these particular platforms created an API, that means it's accessible so you can communicate with it, the use cases or possibilities are almost endless.
APIs help us share flight information between an airline and a travel site that compare fares. They integrate Google Maps into ride-sharing applications, embed YouTube videos directly into a web page. The New York Times has an API that lets you search their database. Even NASA lets you access satellite data and imagery via an API.
The benefits of using APIs is you can use it for automation. In my team or in my company, I may have multiple systems, and I want to automate data between those systems. Systems integration, reporting, robotics, artificial intelligence. As long as we have data that you can use to automate and transfer between platforms via an API, and that data is exposed, you can use it for a variety of use cases. It's relevant to an end user because it can improve his or her life, right? Or help automate their life. You may be using your phone. There may be applications on that phone. They're actually connected to APIs that makes your life more productive. You may not know what's happening behind the hood, but in most cases, you may be capturing data from three or four multiple systems. So it's relevant to the end user in everyday life and everyday work life, but at the same time, relevant to the engineers and developers that build these applications to consume data from various systems. But for me to interact with that flux capacitor, I need an interface. So I have the steering wheel, I have the knobs, and then by initiating all those things at the interface level, I'm able to communicate through that flux capacitor, and then use the car to travel back in time or back into the future, whatever the case may be, right? And that's pretty much an API.
Perfect.